currently I'm all set up to shoot a high-low scenario where I actually have three different tops all at different heights. I have the lower top, which is actually in place currently. And then on the right side, I have one that's maybe about 2 to 3 inches higher than the main top. And on the left, I have one that's about 6 to 8 inches high. What we're going to do today is actually template all of them at the exact same time and show you how we can use the system to separate the pieces. So I'm going to start off with shooting a 1-point plane, and I'm just going to shoot that roughly about in the middle of all of them. Now I'm going to start to shoot my cabinets. So I'm going to start on the far left and start shooting my targets that I set up on the base already. Point one, point two. I'm now going to come to the face of the cabinets. Now I'm going to come down and actually shoot the countertop. Now, something to help differentiate what we're doing, I'm going to shoot this in finish so that you can see where it is. I'm then going to switch back to cabinets, shoot 2 points across the face. The preference is that we shoot the cabinets as much as possible, but if we have to shoot the finished face, maybe an existing top's in place, that's okay. But it's just kind of good to note where it is. So having those marked out in the correct color just helps to simplify things. Now I'm going to shoot my 2 points here and keep working around my tops. Now I'm going to start templating my walls. So I'm going to switch to my wall color and switch to continuous. I can now take my scribe, starting on the right, and I'm shooting this right above the, in this case, 2x3s that are going to be supporting the top. I can also kind of shoot myself going back. So I'm going to hit start new line and start shooting back into where the window actually goes. Start a new line again, and then I'm going to pick up going this direction. I'm not going to be making my top the whole way across, but if I take pictures, it'll explain the story a little bit more to anyone else that needs to see it. So at this point, I'm just going to continue to shoot where these tops. Now that I'm switching over to the left top, I'm going to start shooting those right above where that wood is. So I'm capturing the scribe where it matters. Essentially, that's the big point. Keep going across. And now I'm going to shoot the bottom. This is going to be where my lower top is actually sitting and touching right now. There's one. Now we're going to work on separating the tops first. We could go through and check our measurements as they sit, but we can also go through and actually separate them a little bit ahead of time. So I'm going to rotate my drawing. I'm going to get it as close as I need to, and I'm going to click right there. Now I'm going to go through and fill it as much as I can. And I'm going to extend these back. You can see they actually go past just a tiny bit. So that could mean that we want to take our tops a little over, but we'll figure that out when we get there. I'm going to fillet these together. And I'm going to extend these back to the face because that's what it's actually touching. Now I'm going to come through and check on my overhangs real quick. And I'm going to go through and see exactly what we're getting as far as measurements goes. So on this side here, I am looking at 1 3/16". Yep. And it should be the same on this side. It's exactly. So I'm going to go through an offset. 1.1875. and I'm going to create my cabinets. Now, I'm going to leave my finish lines where they're at because that's what we're obviously making. But now I can start to look at these and say, okay, let's start separating these into separate tops. I'm going to go to multi. I'm going to focus on just this right side right now. I'm going to highlight what matters. I'm going to hit the paste button. I'm going to make sure it says paste here, and I'm going to paste that top up there. Now we'll move it around just to get it where we want. And now I'm going to go to erase, and I'm going to get rid of this because this actually has to belong to the lower top. I'm going to then leave that part go. Now we're going to move the left top. So I'm going to go to multi, and I'm going to grab this. I'm going to hit paste, and we're going to paste that up here and just get it back into the frame. Now we're going to clean this up. So the top piece is pretty simple. We're just going to clean this one out. But now we're going to get rid of what we don't need on the uppers. Well, we don't need any of those wall scribes on the uppers. But we do need those cabinet edges. Those cabinet edges matter in this case. Those cabinet edges, if we look at just the cabinets, look like this. This looks like this. And now we can get rid of this. This is the setback part. That's right by the window. That's not going to be part of the lower top. The lower top's actually sitting perfectly where it is. So there's my lower, there's my uppers. Now I can go to distance and dimensions, and I can start to check and see my framework. So if we come through and start to check a few of these things, we're going to check that 57 and an 8 in the back. That'll be our good check for the moment. Dead on, 57 and an 8th. 13 and a 16th, and 61 and a half. 61 and a half. And 13 and 11 16ths. Perfect. Okay. You can continue this as long as you want, but at this point, we pretty much have our dimensions relatively checked. Now, all we need to do is we need to finish the drawing. So we took all three of our points. We have all three tops. And the reason it works is because we were able to shoot the cabinets where the cabinets are, and then we were able to shoot the walls where it actually is going to touch. So now we're going to finish this out. So let's go through and work on just our lower top. We know that we actually need to touch in some spots. So we're going to go to color and revise. We're just going to change these two to wall. That way, we know we can actually tie those right into that. Now we're going to go in here and we're going to add in our other overhang. So we're going to leave the sides where they are. We're going to go offset. We're just going to do an inch and a half on the front. We can fillet that together. And now we have our lower. Now we're going to work on our uppers. Now I'm going to keep everything just the way it is and just offset it. I'm not going to create anything parallel or perpendicular or anything. We're just going to try to create these as is and go from there. But we can offset. I've got inch and a half. We're just going to do inch and a half the whole way around. Now, I can fillet parts of this, right? But when I get to this corner, well, let's say I want to extend it back into the wall. I can extend that back. We'll go and fillet it actually overextend. And then I can erase this extra line. You can see now I actually had the ability to capture exactly that little ear to let it go back into the sill a little bit just to add some accent. We're going to do the same thing on this side. Offset. And fill it. We're going to get rid of what we don't need here. And there we are. We now have three individual tops that we were able to shoot at one time. So we're going to just clean this up. We're going to push this over to here. We're going to go back to select, grab the next piece, and we're going to move this one into here. And there you have it. Three separate tops, all in the exact same template.